the Pat Maine Radio Hour. Up next, it's time to make some predictions on what parade floats we'll be seeing at Deerfest. This year's parade theme is deer, just like every year, so we're not exactly reinventing the wheel here. But first, I need to address something. I know the last couple of shows took a strange turn, with people coming on talking nonsense about certain people passing away. Listen, I know everybody who steps foot in and out of this town, so I'd sure as heck know if Wendy Davis died or went missing. You know, they say I'm confused. I hear them in the hall murmuring about me. Well, Pat's got a rusty ticker, but my head's as clear as those skies are gonna be on the opening day of Deerfest. Somebody's trying to twist this story around, and I don't know quite why. But I'm here to tell you that everything's gonna be okay. Wendy Davis is alive and well, and you can rest easy knowing that Wendy Davis's family beef jerky will be available this Sunday, just like it always is. Now, with all that settled, let's talk about the, what was it we were talking about? Deer, yes, something deer. Hold on, let me think real quick. Right. So first, I just want to mention that I know the last couple of shows took a strange turn, with people coming on talking nonsense about certain people passing away. Wait, did we talk about this already? I think we... No, I definitely said this already, but it was a great topic lined up with... I'm so sorry, it's just not coming to me. Perhaps we need to end it here for now. We'll pick this up later. Deer. It had something to do with deer. I know. I wrote it down. Why can't I just What was it? Maybe Norman took my notes. Oh, gotta see Norman. Gotta see Norman.
Every night was bingo night at the Valhalla nursing home. Each time Rose drew a ball from the cage and called out its number, some of the residents shouted bingo, no matter what was on their cards. Some of them sat mute, their cards full, never calling out. Some of them would try to steal the ball from her. Some of them would chastise the others for acting out. It was like herding a clowder of cats. Rose didn't mind. She liked cats. She knew she was where she was supposed to be, with her little Vikings, waiting for the hero to come. Tonight, the residents were restless, more so than usual. Ati was wearing Blum's coveralls again. Tor stood by the phone. Too late. Rose saw the hammer in his hand. The garden lights started to flicker, the darkness and rain pressing against the windows. The time drew nigh.
More of those kids' lunchboxes.
Thank you. For some ritual murder! People were right. Here. fast.
Another cult stash?
The 81st annual Deer Fest was just around the corner. Everyone in Bright Falls was bustling. There were banners to be hung, pies baked, deer masks sold. Bright Falls had made the top 100 American small town lists for its modest, rustic charm. The town expected a lot of tourists this year, but a shadow hung over the Deer Fest preparations. The forecast promised rain. Fearful whispers promised more murders. The police were on high alert. Sheriff Breaker had deputies patrolling the streets at night. Bright Falls was no stranger to odd happenings, but to cancel Deerfest? Out of the question. The townsfolk were anxious, their anticipation mixed with fear. People had restless dreams. The lights seemed dimmer. Floodwater pressed in on the town, and the shadows poured in with it.